Subscribe to Film Companion for your film fix. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an update. Amazing. Hi, Rakul.
Hello.
I never actually talk to anyone as they hang
upside down. Absolutely. I love it. This is my world. I always say that my world is the most straightest when I'm hanging upside down.
You look very comfortable.
I am. Let me come out and make it more normal for you.
Yes, thank you. That would have been a very awkward conversation.
Awkward conversation.
Okay, so what does hanging upside down do for you?
I think for me, it's a lot of blood rush. It's a lot of, so it just opens my brain cells, I feel. I can breathe very well. It's a very calm, meditative state. And especially hanging for 3 to 5 minutes is what I do every day.
No way.
Yes, yes. So that 3 to 5 minutes of blood rush just opens up my mind.
Clarity.
Clarity of thought and just is a good start to the day.
Wow. For me. Well, you look great doing it.
Thank you. Thank you. So shall we?
We shall walk.
We shall walk.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so we're going to be walking down.
We're walking to a little cafe which has lots of healthy food that you can eat.
Yes.
So your Twitter header says, create a life
you don't need a
vacation from. Do you think you managed to do that?
Absolutely. So I'm a spiritual person, if I can say so, and I feel that right now when people ask me, how do you manage so many things? Because people who know me know that I love to multitask and I love to do a lot of stuff together. Hmm. Like even when it comes to my yoga, even if I'm shooting at 7 a.m., I'll come at 5. I'll do my workout and my yoga no matter what. Huh. So I just feel that I enjoy doing everything so much, the process of it, and nobody is asking me to do 4 films at a time. I just love it and it's my choice and it's like a vacation for me. I'm living my dream, right? So many people die to be here.
Right.
So I never get tired.
You're 18.
Yeah.
You're a Punjabi girl from Delhi.
Yeah.
And you're doing a Kannada film. You don't know the language. How did you do that?
I don't know.
Did you just ratta maro?
I just ratta marod. Huh. I was very good with ratta. Huh. I know because that's what I did with my social science in school. So I just got that film and I always wanted to do films but I didn't know how and when and what. Huh. So I decided to do that. I say, chalo, let's see what the experience is going to be like. Huh. I had no idea of how
Where was it shot?
Bangalore.
Okay.
And I had no idea of, in fact, the first call I even refused to them. And I had no idea there's a South Indian industry. Huh. I didn't know there's regional cinema. Because being from an army background, I never grew up on a dose of films.
Hmm. But so, you wanted to do films.
I wanted to do films. So I told them, I'm like, I'm not going to do South films. I'll do Hindi. As if I have some godfather sitting in Hindi, you know. So that was my response to them as an 18-year-old, 12th standard child. And then they called my dad and they said, you know, it's a remake of a very big Tamil film. Please watch the film, do it. So I decided to do that film for pocket money.
Right.
I thought I'm going to make money in lakhs and I'll be the first one
and
in my
parents
friends
were
to...
cool.
Oh yeah, very cool. Huh. In fact, it was my mom because I got that offer 1 week after I did my pictures, my first portfolio. And
within a week, you had your first film offer.
First film offer, because they saw my pictures somewhere. In fact, it was so freaky that they called my dad and they said, "We've seen her date of birth, and she's going to be a big star one day, and we want us." And I didn't even know anything. I was like, "Really? Okay." So the reason I just agreed to do that film was, "Chalo, I'll make some money and I'll buy a Ritz car, and I'll be the first one in my friends to have a car."
That was the initial motivation.
Huh. So that was my first brush with acting.
Huh.
And I just went on set. I met them on the first day of shoot. You won't believe me.
No way.
Yeah.
So script root kuch nahi pata.
Wo, it was a remake. So I saw the original
thing.
And then unhone mujhe scenes diye. They gave me the scenes and I crammed it up. Actually, one day before I met them, I learned. And they told me what it meant. And I thought of how I would do it in English. And I just remember doing it. And they were like, oh my God, she's learned the lines. And I was like, oh, okay, yeah. So I was like this
lost child. That was seen as dedication.
Yeah, but to me, that's how it happened. You know, I would just cram it up. And that's exactly what happened even in Telugu when I started my first film. Cram it up, but make an effort to understand every word.
Right. So that you get the emotion.
Right. You get the emotion, and that's why now, after having done so many films, I speak the language.
I don't think we should attempt to cross the road and keep talking. Okay.
Let's cross.
Okay, we're holding up Mumbai traffic here. Now.
A lot of traffic.
What I'm curious about is that there are all these different languages that you're working in, right? And then in each of these industries, you're at a different level of success, fame.
Right.
You know, you're a massive star in Telugu, in Hindi. After the success of Dede Pyarde, you know, things are really moving for you. How hard is that? You know, sort of figuring out, okay, here I'm here, there I'm there.
That's a good question. Actually, not that difficult if you never take your success seriously, never take your stardom seriously. I think for me, the fact that I'm an actor, and I've said this down south also when they asked me after the film's doing well, is that I treat it like a job. I treat it like a 9-to-6 job or maybe a 12-hour-15 job, like any other person goes for their job. And for me, the stardom is not something that I believe that it's not gotten to my head. But yeah, I can say that, you know, when Dede was releasing, for the first time I felt a little bit of nervous energy. I wouldn't say I was stressed, but there was just that excitement, anxiousness that there are going to be so many more eyes on you. It's not just regional, it's not just the South industry, but so many more eyes and comparisons, you know, because I was in a film with Ajay Sir and Tabu Ma'am, and then obviously you're going to be compared. But I think that was the first time right before the screening, half an hour before the screening is when I felt, oh, this is the first time I'm feeling butterflies. Because I've never felt butterflies even before a release down south or here. But yeah, otherwise I don't really take it seriously. I don't think I've taken the stardom part too seriously. So I'm just doing my job.
I get that. But in the day-to-day thing, right? So I remember I was doing an interview with Priyanka, and she was saying that when she first went to LA, she said, you know, I had to walk into offices and tell them who I am. And she was a globally known star, and they didn't know her work. Does that happen to you, and is that annoying?
It's not annoying. I understand that that would happen, and I was prepared for it. You know, even now there are so many times that at least before Dede, I had to write, and I used to say that I know that people wouldn't know. How much do I know of Bengali industry, or how much do I know of Marathi industry? I don't, you know. And it's fair enough, you know, for people who don't watch. So I'm aware of the fact that they wouldn't know me, but I didn't know how to introduce myself. So I would write exactly that in the messages. I remember, you know, sending messages saying, hi, this is Rakul. I'm not too sure if you know me, but I majorly work in the South, and right now I'm doing this, and please let me know when's a good time to call, you know. So, and there were people who responded, of course we know who you are, like, are you silly? I'm like, you know, I don't know. Don't know how to.
But it doesn't get awkward.
As you know, I think if you make it a big deal in your head, oh my God, people don't know me.
Right, but they should know me.
Yeah, but then you know that they wouldn't. Like, I always think about it, like I said, that I don't know other regional actors, except for the industries that I'm working in. So it's it's fine. It just gets a little awkward as to where you wanna, how are you gonna introduce yourself and how do you tell your body of work? I've done this. It's quite difficult to tell right. about the 17, 18 films that you've done or the kind of, the magnitude of those films.
Yeah.
But then I think these days especially, people are pretty aware.
They're Googling.
They're Googling. And plus, I think after Bahubali, there's just been that whole phase where people know and they have their eyes on the certain content, film content. So people know who's working where and at least the top three, four for sure.
But it's never frustrating.
No, it's not been frustrating so far. I mean, it's been, how am I going to do this? But I have to say that it's like I'm a struggler back again. That's for sure, you know, when I mean, post day things are different, but if I had to call and if I had to fix a meeting, I was like, damn, I'm back to scratch one. But it's never been a problem.
You're good with that.
I'm good with that because it's my decision of doing that, you know. I can be very much comfortable in my comfort zone where people would follow and, you know, there'll be so many screaming out the name, but then I want more and I want to explore another industry and I'm prepared for that. So it's never been frustrating.
You know, it's. I was curious that you debuted with Yaariya, which of course was a success. But by the time that finished shooting, you'd already signed on the Telugu films and that just kind of took off and you chose to stay there.
Right.
Did you ever regret not cashing on to the success of Yaariya and sort of being here and kind of taking that forward?
I didn't regret. In fact, I feel on the hindsight, I'm glad it happened the way it happened because I was very young when Yaariya happened. And I had no idea.
Oh my God,
that's the
brown
sheenie. Okay, thank you.
Oh man, that looks good.
Yeah. So,
and this is gluten-free and dairy-free.
This is gluten-free and dairy-free and sugar-free.
Okay, since you have to talk, I'm eating.
Please go ahead.
So, did you?
I didn't regret. In fact, I feel that whatever happens, happens for the best. I didn't know any better at that point. I finished shooting for Yaariya. I started shooting for my first film in Telugu 2 days after that. That released 3 months before Yaariya released because Yaariya took about a year to release. And that became a hit. I signed another 2-3 films. You know, so for a person who's not from the film industry to suddenly get that sort of appreciation anywhere and get good films, I just signed on to those films because I never believed in the concept of leaving the work that you're getting in order to find more work.
Sure.
And I knew the kind of...
What is this?
This is also almond butter, raspberry, chocolate, same, dairy-free, gluten-free.
Oh my God.
Yeah. I've not tried that. That's a new addition.
That looks insane. It's so good. That's so good.
So I just signed those films. And I didn't even know that you're supposed to be in Bombay in order to get more work. Because that wasn't the case in the South. When the film
so there's
released,
no mentor for this. There wasn't anybody guiding me through this.
Huh. And I didn't know any better that you're supposed to be here. You're supposed to do your meetings, be seen, be styled a certain way. You know, I was the kind of person who would wear my sport shoes and go for a meeting, right? During my first few years in films. Not during Yaariya, but during my first few years. And I don't regret it because I feel that if I had continued working then, I was too raw.
Yeah.
I don't think I had the finesse of my art that I have little bit, you know, it always gets better. And all the experience in the South has only made me more confident and more, more confident with my craft and more confident as a person. And I know how to deal and talk to people, you know, otherwise I would just say, no, but I don't like this. And, you know, I call a spade in which you can't
learn
always
the art
do.
Of diplomacy.
Maybe not diplomacy, but just being somewhere in between. I don't think I can still be diplomatic. You'll see it on my face, even if I'm saying something else, but people who know me will know it on my face. But I just feel that I'm much more prepared now. I'm not raw.
Sure.
And I don't think that if you make you don't get too many opportunities over and over again, you know. And I'm glad that it happened when I'm more prepared.
I mean
if after Yaariya I was given a role like a Dede, I don't think I would have pulled it off. I don't think I would have been intimidated at that point. I don't think I would have understood the complexity of emotions so much. So I'm so glad that it happened now when I'm ready to give it my all and be there.
But you said that there's so much more pressure here in terms of the PAPS, in terms of airport looks.
Right.
So is this all completely a Bombay thing? I mean, do you not have paparazzi?
No, you don't have, but Manav has sent his paparazzi to Hyderabad now. And who's always sitting outside the airport, which I was like, why are you here also? This was one place which didn't have paparazzi. But yeah, I think it's a lot of unwanted stress.
How do you deal with it?
I don't take it. I walk around like this. I've been photographed so many times in my chappals, with my oiled hair, with no makeup. Like yesterday, I was out without makeup, just getting a hair wash, and I got papped, and it's fine. You know, I feel the more you pressurize yourself and start taking yourself too seriously when you're off duty, I think you're just complicating your life.
Yeah.
People understand that you're not working right now, and they've seen you when you're in hair and makeup, and you cannot, it's normal to not look your best all the time. So I don't really bother about it, you know. I'm okay if I'm repeating my bag. I'm fine if obviously I'm not going to be dressed in pajamas, but casual, and if I'm not in makeup, I'm absolutely fine with it. Yeah.
So what's your biggest struggle right now?
I don't like the word struggle.
What, challenge?
Challenge? No, I don't like the word challenge also.
That's a good word.
I'll tell you how I treat it. Huh. I feel whatever you're looking like, okay, I'm really spiritual, and my friends joke and call me Sadhguru 2.0 version. So I'm going to just say that before it sounds like a moral science class. But I just feel that for me, whatever I'm doing, I enjoy. And the desire is to be able to do more films and do great characters. And the journey that it is, the beauty of it is the journey itself. So I don't like to call it a struggle or a challenge. I am enjoying every day, even if I have to do those 10 calls and say, hi, I'd like to meet you. I do that. I did not know how to do that till I did Dede. I used to always wonder. In fact, I told a few people, I told my team, I said, you know, are they not going to feel ye to chep ho gaye hai, ye to bar bar call kar rahe hai. Because in the South, it doesn't work like that. It's a single manager who will talk to the teams.
And you directly don't call.
You never call. And I didn't know that school, and I didn't want people to think that she is being a cling, you know, she's being too
piling on
or she's pestering us over and over again. But here, that's what I heard that people do. You know, you're supposed to call, and they appreciate if you show that you're genuinely interested.
You're keen,
In fact, I've gone up to people and said, I want to do that film. I've been told that you're supposed to straight up go and say, I want to do. So correct. So don't think
so
that,
I'm doing,
you know,
it.
So I'm doing it, yeah, you know, yeah, because yeah. I don't understand how else am I going to ask for work. But there's no shying away. I mean, if you don't ask for it yourself, who else is going to do it? So I believe that I've kind of understood how to ask for work.
Is there a different set of rules for every industry you work in?
Absolutely. I think it's not rules, but both the industries work very differently in terms of how you talk to people, in terms of actor projection, you know, like we're talking about the off-duty style and paps and how you contact people, or, you know, you're in a party to kind of make contact. That doesn't happen in the South.
Really?
It doesn't happen in the South. You get a film, you're good in the film, you get some more films. They see.
There's no networking.
There is no networking whatsoever needed. If you yourself want to network, that's another story. But I've never had the need to network. And actors are very friendly. You know, you kind of make your own little circle. It's basically purely on your film's success and how your film's done and how well you've done in the film. Whereas it's very different here. It's all about a lot of networking, being present everywhere, whether it's award functions or
being seen,
you know, being papped. But there's a fun to it as well, I feel.
You enjoy it?
I don't mind it. I mean, there's no option, right? So instead of cribbing, you better enjoy it. So makes instead sense. Of just making a sad face when the paps come, just smile to them and say good evening, you know. So for me, it's that. I mean, when you can't really do anything about it, you got to take it in your stride and just be happy about it.
Correct. No, makes sense. By the way, this is amazing. Nice. I've read this interview of yours in, I think it was The Hindu, and they described you as a star heroine. And in that interview, you said that you really want to play now a rural character, not wear any makeup. And why is that important? And what is a star heroine?
Star heroine in the South is somebody who has worked with all the stars. So they start calling you a star heroine, or, you know, when you
have
a
your co-star.
That plus, you know, when your films have done a certain amount, when you have a huge fan base, so they call you a star heroine. Hmm. But yes, I think, you know, after a point, you want to go to set and look forward to doing something different and not the usual. And I think after having done, I'm doing my 18th film in Telugu right now, I just feel that people take you more seriously maybe when you are maybe crying, which is actually the toughest, the easiest thing to do.
Yeah.
But people just take you more seriously in a hard-hitting role. And more than people taking you seriously, you want to challenge yourself. You don't want to be repetitive and get bored with what you do. So I want to I have done rural characters, but now I want to do something more in that, you know, or maybe do more subject oriented or content oriented cinema. So I think that's what that interview said.
So is it hard to find those roles yet? Do people still see you very much in the sort of attractive urban
in Telugu, you know,
in Telugu and in Hindi?
Hindi, I've just begun. So it's both are very different. You know,
okay.
What I'm looking at in my life, at my career point in Telugu, is not what I want to do in Hindi.
So tell me what you're looking at for both.
See, Hindi, I've just begun and people have just seen me. I feel Dede is like a showreel, literally, for people to see me, because the girl in Yaria is very different from the girl in Dede.
Sure.
So I would want to do the dance masalas, you know, the commercial bit. I'd love to do something like a Pink. I'd love to experiment. Whereas in Telugu, I would want to do more content based cinema,
because you've already done the masala.
Because I've done the masala. Yeah. And it's not like I won't do masala, but if given a choice to pick, I'd want to do content, because people know me for that, you know, they've seen me in the songs and the songs have been big hits. And I think now I want to bring that little change of the cinema speaking for itself. Yeah. And I think now I can do it. Mm. You know, there's always a particular stage in life where you can. I mean, today if I say I want to do a film which rides on my shoulder here, who knows Rakul and who's going to come and watch Rakul? Rakul's not a Priyanka Chopra or even someone, you know, so I'm relatively new. So I need to have those 5-6 films before people know me, before I decide to do something to do with content. Whereas in Telugu, that's not the case. So this is a good time for me to start doing that.
Are you fairly realistic about
you are? People find it very hard to believe, but people who know me, they know I'm going to be like, why are you going to go and watch my film? Let's chill for the same time. Arey, it's not good, you know. Don't waste time. 3 years. I have done that to another director friend of mine who has not seen a film of mine which wasn't good, because he booked tickets thrice and I didn't let him go. I said, you better chill with us, it's going to be better, it's going to be more fun than watching that 3-hour film. So it's okay. I mean, it's good to be happy, you know.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. On a less happier note, tell me, what are the, again, I'll use the word challenge, of you know, being a young female actor in a post-Me Too era of the film industry.
Right.
Right? You've been very supportive whenever you've talked about it. But there are situations, you know, like Ade De Vyarde, where you have an actor, Alok Nath, who's been accused of sexual harassment, much worse.
Right.
The producer and lead, Ajay Devgan, has of course said that all of this was shot much before. And, you know, there's
which
nothing...
It was.
Which it was. And which, yeah, there's nothing you can do about it. But in your head, how do you reconcile it? You know, is that difficult? And what do you do when situations like that crop up?
You know, I had finished shooting for the film when all this started, so I never met him after the whole Me Too thing started. But like the team said, that we had finished shooting and we had shot in 4 different locations, Manali, London, 2 sets in Bombay. There's no way you could have reshot it, you know. It's like the entire film being reshot again. And it you know, and I don't like to judge a person till the time it's been proved. There's an allegation. It's not with respect to ABC here. It's in any general scenario till the time it's been proved. Though my heart goes out to the women, and I know that if I was in that spot, I would be furious and I'd be boiling. And but till the time it's been proved, you can't really call him, put him at fault. And that's how I see it. I mean, it is sad, but I think it's glad that Me Too happened, because it just is going to make it a safer space for women. I think people are going to be scared, and thanks to the social media and the way the media has come out, there's just so much information outside, and it can just travel like this. All somebody needs to do is put a tweet.
Tell me, on a day-to-day basis, do you feel that anything's changed for women in the movie business?
Absolutely. I think, like I said, that the whole people are going to be scared now to even have that conversation, or even have just a flirty conversation, a casual flirting, which a lot of people say. Now no one's going to say, "Acha, let's discuss it over dinner also." I think that's for sure happened. But again, I have always said that I have never faced it. So for me, it's still the same how it was earlier. And I've never faced it in the South. Touch wood. I only know what I would do if I would. Yeah. And I never faced it here. So to me, there hasn't been much change, because it's always been like this. Mm-hmm. And also, there is another thing that I think, when people see, it's an opportunist world. And this is my message to all the girls out there, that never let it show on your face that you need it real bad. Mm-hmm. Never let desperation come on your face, because human nature is of being an opportunist. It's not only in our film industry, anywhere, you know. So if they know that you need it, they're going to try and make the most of it, whether it's for a girl or a boy.
Yeah.
You know, that's human nature. So I think just believe in yourself and know that you're good, and never let desperation take the decision.
Be able to walk away.
Yeah.
So you have a home here and a home in Hyderabad.
Yes, I have the split of Ajay Devgan, like one leg in Hyderabad and one in Bombay.
And so far, so good. You're just racking up the air miles and
I can definitely give it to you in writing that I think I have the maximum air miles here in Bombay. This morning, someone was asking me, because I got in last evening, so were you here? I said, no, I just landed. And they're like, you were here 2 days back. I said, yeah, but I wasn't here for 2 days. So you're doing Hyderabad, Bombay, Andheri, Bandra. I said, it's easier.
It is easier.
Yeah. Right now, Andheri, Bandra is not that easy with the rains. That 1 hour flight is much easier.
This is true. This is true. And do you ever find that you've been in a position where you have to choose, you know, and sort of in terms of prioritize?
Absolutely. Yeah. It was a very difficult, I have to mention this, that in Telugu, I've always done 3 to 4 films at a time. And that's how it works, you know. The schedules are very different. You do 10 days in a month, and then your film is spread over 5-6 months, and you at all points doing 3 to 4 films, which is why in 4 years I did 16 films. And when I decided to take up Dede, they said that 6 months is what we need, because you can't adjust dates with Ajay sir. So I happened to sign 2 films in Tamil, just happened, and then I signed Dede, and then I couldn't take up anything in Telugu. I knew it was the right decision because I knew what the script was, but I had to go through so much media bashing at that point because I didn't announce anything in Telugu, and Spider had released before that. So there was all kinds of news that because Spider has not worked, she has not got any film, has her stardom gone? You know, like how they love to write things. So I used to just see it and then just smile to myself. So that was a phase where I had to consciously tell myself that it's okay. You sometimes need to go take 2 steps back to take a longer jump, a plunge into something different. And that was a phase where, you know, I had to figure how am I going to manage Hindi and Telugu without getting mentally disturbed, because I didn't want to, you can't keep reading like that every day when your own home industry is writing things that why are you not announcing a Telugu film. But then I started telling them that there's only 365 days in a year, and there's only 4 films I can do, whereas I'm working in 3 Tamil and 1 Hindi, so I can't. So it's not about the language, it's about the different films that I'm doing. But yes, it works at a very different rate, and it does take time. And now after the film released, everybody's calmed down. So I also kept saying that, you know, I mean, there is a role which is a full-length role. It's not like I'm just there for 4 songs. So there was so much prep that went into the role. There was dance classes and bartending and God knows what all. So after they saw the movie, then everyone calmed down.
Ah, so all is well.
All's well that ends well.
Okay, and last question. What do we see you in next? What's the next release? Which language?
Next immediate release is Telugu, which is on August 9th, which is Manmadhudu with Nag sir. And then is October 2nd, Marjava, which is with Siddharth. And then I have another film that I start shooting in Telugu right now in about 15 days' time.
Do you ever get this mixed up that, you know, wait, which language, what am I doing, which way?
No, thankfully not. Like I said, like I pack up, right? Every time they say pack up, I am back to being Rakul.
Right.
So I literally work in compartmentalizing things. I'm like, okay, Bombay, chunk, done. Now I'm going to Hyderabad, now just, that's gone, now this is how it works. But I'm a walking, talking timetable. That's a problem that my friends have with me and I have with myself also. But then I'm pretty good with compartmentalizing sections in my brain, so in my head, so I haven't messed it up yet. Yes, sometimes what I was shooting for a bilingual and I was talking it in English to somebody and doing Tamil dialogues and Telugu and then Hindi, and I'm like, what is happening? I am a Punjabi who's talking in Telugu and Tamil on set, and then English I was giving an interview. I'm like, what? Wait, this khichdi happening of languages. But yeah,
how wonderful.
Yeah, but it's great. I think it's lovely, and you get to learn so much more.
Absolutely.
With different languages. And
you know, I really think lines are blurring. In
Absolutely.
Another few years, there's nobody going to be saying that industry and this industry. It's all one industry.
It's
you know?
All one industry.
Yeah.
And as actors, you know, I think even makers are now understanding that all you need to do is bring good content to the screen for audiences. Who would have thought Bahubali is going to be that big?
Yeah.
Who would have thought Prabhas is going to have a Saho which is going to be like that, or an Arjun Reddy becoming a Kabir Singh,
sure,
and doing the numbers that it's doing.
Yeah.
So it just shows that content is the same. Language is the only barrier, and I think that's really blurring now.
Yeah,
so,
it is.
Yeah.
And on that happy note,
and the happy brownies.
And the happy brownies. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
And keep juggling.
Thank you.
Thanks. Please eat.
Hi guys, this is Rakul, and if you like this video, then please subscribe to Film Companion.